much you weigh. You weigh too much for them. That's why they couldn't hold you. That's why they dropped you. They thought they cripple you, but they don't realize, baby, God's about to take you. He's about to sit you down at the king's table. I wish I had somebody who feel like they've been dropped in here today. I wish King David was here. Even though King Saul was there, even though Saul hated David, David thought about, is there anybody left alive of the household of Saul? I wish I had somebody right now. You've been dropped in your life. Somebody hurt you in your life. Somebody let you down. They didn't even mean to hurt you, but they hurt you. They don't know how bad they hurt you, but they hurt you. But one thing they forgot to kill you. You're still alive today, baby. You still got your right mind. I need somebody to holler at the preacher right now. God, there's time for you to sit down at the king's table, because God hasn't forgotten about you. I prophesy right now, if you have to lift there, you're going to get there. If they have to carry you there, you're going to get there. If somebody got to roll you there, you're going to get there. I need somebody to give God praise right now and tell your neighbor to neighbor. God's trying to tell you something. I don't know what you've been through in all your life, but this is your year. All your scars, they were for your good. All your pain, it was for your good. God using that mess to give you a message. The one that hurt you really was helping you. They taught you to run back to God. They taught you how to pray. You don't need no book on prayer. You don't need prayer 101. Just a little pain in your life. Just some trouble in your life will make you run to the altar and say, Lord, here I am. I need help. I need your power. I need your spirit. I need your anointing. Tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor, God's trying to tell you something. Pick yourself up by your bootstrap. Dust yourself off. Say, for God I live, for God I die. It might not feel good, but it's going to be good. Say, neighbor, I don't like this word Pastor giving us today, but I just believe I'm going to chew on it some more. Say, neighbor, it hurt coming in, but it hurt coming out. But God's looking for pillows. God's looking for somebody he can use in the house. Somebody already been disappointed. Somebody that's already been let down. Somebody that's already been rejected. One more rejection ain't gonna kill nobody. If you already been hurt, already been rejected, it made you better. It didn't make you better. It made you better. So tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, all the hell I've been through, it made me better. My past didn't disqualify me, but my past qualified me. I wouldn't be able to stand here today and tell somebody I was messed up, but he fixed me up. I was down, but he picked me up. I was out, but he brought me in. I was rejected, but he accepted me. I was hated, but he taught me how to love. I was by myself, but he taught me that if I be for you, who can be against you? Say, neighbor, give me your hand. I'm about to pray with you right now. I prophesy that your ladder shall be better than your former. I prophesy, if God be for you, who can be against you? Somebody stand up and put your hand on your hip and give God a